Welcome to the Unlocking LaTeX Graphics channel. On this channel, I'll be providing tutorials on TikZ and PGF plots, which are tools for creating graphics directly inside your LaTeX documents. I am Tammy Kolda, your guide. I've been using these tools for a long time, and I understand a lot of your frustrations and needs. This is the first in a sequence of videos where I will be covering materials in my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, which is linked below. I will be happy to try and answer your questions, so please go ahead and post them. And of course, if you like this channel, share it with your colleagues and click the subscribe button. Today's lesson is going to start at the beginning, creating a drawing canvas and a few simple graphics. I'm assuming you've already used LaTeX. If not, I will put some links to helpful tutorials to get started in LaTeX. And I'm going to be doing everything in Overleaf, link below, so that you can follow along. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and go to our web browser and go to Overleaf. This is a great online LaTeX editor. And so we'll just go ahead and create a new project. It'll be a blank project to start. And we'll say, getting started with TikZ. All right. And now it loads up and we're ready to go. I'm just going to do a few things. I'm going to close that off because we're not going to need to do anything there. And I'll make this view a little bit bigger so that you can see everything. And then we'll switch to where I don't show you the top of the screen so that we have a little more real estate to work with. Before we can do anything with TikZ, we have to include the TikZ package in our preamble. So we'll go ahead to the top of our document, before begin document, and put in use package and then TikZ. And now we're ready to go. Just to make things a little bit easier for me later, I'm going to go ahead and also use another package called parskip. And all this does is it makes it so that I have a little bit of vertical space between paragraphs and no horizontal indentation. It's just going to make things a little prettier for our tutorial. I'm also going to go ahead and comment out this graphics package because we're not going to need it today. Great. So now we're ready to create some graphics. We're now set up to start drawing some pictures. So let's go down to the main part of the document and draw our first picture. So you want to contain your picture inside of the TikZ picture environment. So we'll go ahead and add that in. This is our drawing canvas. Now that we have our canvas, let's draw some help lines to guide us. So just do draw help lines grid, and then I'll make it a 3x2 grid of help lines, and everything has to end with a semicolon. So we'll go ahead and compile that, and we get our grid of help lines. Now let's go ahead and draw a line here. So we'll draw, and we'll do 0.3 in XY coordinates, 2, 3, 1.5. And we end every line with a semicolon. And so now you see that we get a line that shows up. Now, an interesting thing is that draw is actually a shortcut in TikZ for path with a draw option. This will become important later on to understand that this is what's really going on with the path. If I didn't have draw here as an option, there simply would be no line. It's still there. There's a path there. It's just invisible to us. But we'll go ahead and draw that line. And then we'll go back to the shortcut where we just use draw, makes it a little more compact and obvious what's going on. And then I'll go ahead and make this line red just to make it a little prettier and stand out. So now we've drawn our first line and we can go ahead and comment out this grid of help lines so that all we're left with is our picture. Okay, so that first picture went great. I think we're ready to draw another. Let's go ahead and draw a triangle. So let me type a triangle here and then we'll go ahead and put in our TikZ picture. And we'll draw a 2x2 grid of help lines to get me started. And so we are ready there. Now I'm going to go ahead and type draw. I'm going to make this red just so it stands out. We'll start at the origin. And then I want to go ahead and I'm going to make an equilateral triangle of each side is length 2 and each angle internally is 60 degrees. So I could calculate, you know, where that is in XY coordinates, but I can also use polar coordinates. So I could say 60, that means 60 degrees. It always does it in degrees. And I use a colon instead of a comma to indicate it's a polar coordinate. And then I'm going to say a distance of 2. And so let's just see what I get here. So I get this line from 0, 0 up to the top of the triangle at a point 2 away, an angle 60 degrees from 0, 0. And then I can go ahead and draw the next part of the triangle. I'll go down to 2, 0. So I can do it as 2, 0. Or I could do it as 0 degrees, a distance of 2. Those work out the same. Okay, so that's a polar coordinate. And 2, 0 is the equivalent Cartesian coordinate. Now I'll close up the triangle by going back to 0, 0. But now I haven't actually closed the path. So what we really want to do is cycle. And that tells it that this path is connected, the end to the beginning. And so now we've drawn our triangle. We can go ahead and remove our help lines. And there we are. Let's figure out how to fill our objects with color. So let's go ahead over here and type filling an object, just so we know what we're learning about. And I'm just going to copy the triangle example we used before, give us sort of a quick start. I'll put that help grid back on, and then I'm going to compile that. So we have our triangle, and now suppose I want to fill it with color, I can just type fill. And now it has filled that up with red. Now it's using red because that's the default color, because I put red at the beginning. But I could fill it with something else. I could say fill equals orange. And now it's filled with orange and outlined with red. Maybe I think that orange is a little too bright. I can sort of modify that color with this exclamation point 10. And that says to make it 10% orange and the remainder white. Now let me go ahead and add a little bit more to this picture. I'm gonna make this a 3x3 grid to make it a bit easier for me. And then I'm going to draw a square. And rather than type this all out, I'm just going to go ahead and paste this in. So we have a square that starts at 0.51. We're going to go over to 2.51, up to 2.53, and down back to 0.53. And then we're going to cycle. So let's see how that comes out. And so that's a blue triangle. This is on top of our triangle, because it comes afterwards. Now we're going to go ahead and type fill here. And now we see that this gets filled up with blue. Now, suppose I want to make that a lighter color of blue. Since blue is already the default color, I can just say dot. Dot means whatever the default color of the path is. And then I can make it lighter with the exclamation point. And I'll also make that 10% blue, the remainder white. So that's this neat use of dot to reference the default color. Now this is filled, and notice that it covers up not only the grid, but also the triangle behind it. And so we'll go ahead and change the order of this. Actually want that square to be behind my triangles. I'm going to go ahead and put it behind and compile it like this. And now I can turn off the grid. All right, so now we know how to fill objects up. I want to give you a little bit of detail about this notion of move to versus line to. So let's go ahead and title this move to versus line to in our pictures. And we're going to just go ahead and copy this triangle example again. And then I'm just in the mood for a teal triangle now. So we'll go ahead and make a teal triangle, and we'll go ahead and fill that. And then I'll also change the help lines to be 2x3. And so now we have a little teal triangle here. This dash dash that we have in our draw command is what is called a line to operation. It means draw a line between the two coordinates. We don't have to have that line. So when I get to the end here, I could just go ahead and say 0, 1, -1, 3. And so this blank space here where I have nothing is a move to operation. So I'm just jumping from my previous coordinate to the next one without drawing a line and without connecting the path. And then when I do that, I have this secondary line, which I could have drawn separately, but maybe I just didn't feel like retyping everything. And then I can draw the second line. So that's the difference between or move to, which is just a jump, and then line to is this dash dash operation. The last thing I'll talk about in this video is fill opacity. So what if you want to be able to see through the object that you draw to some object underneath? So let's go ahead and title this little section, fill opacity. And we're going to go ahead and copy our filling an object example from before, because that's a great one that we can use to demonstrate fill opacity. All right. So I'm going to re-add the help lines here and go ahead and compile that. And now we see this picture that we have here. And so we can play around. So let's look at this triangle at the end. And let's go ahead and add fill. And then there's a space. So some of the keys in TikZ have spaces in it. So fill opacity. And then we can do something like 0.5. And now we see when we compile it that we can see through our triangle to what's underneath. We see a little bit of the help lines and we see the blue square. If I made the opacity 0, that means there's nothing there. So it's completely see-through. And if I make the opacity 1, that's the default value. It's completely opaque. You cannot see through it. And so I'll go ahead and make this 0.5 and comment out the help lines. And now we see our nice little picture where we can see through the top triangle to the square underneath. All right, everybody, thanks for watching today. It's been great having you here. Just as a reminder, this is the video series Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. It's based on my book of the same name, which is linked below. If you like this channel, please go ahead and subscribe, tell your colleagues, buy the book.